used or getting, you know, more legal entanglements in the Court of Appeals or in the Supreme Court, which might further delay this case. Mm-hmm. Of course, I'm speculating on what.
But that could be a factor.
That could be a factor.
Mirna, how do you deal with all these, you know, legal gobbledygook? Maybe to for you, bilang ano pamilya ng biktima, mahirap intindihin tong mga technicalities minsan, hindi ba? Nakita kita sa isang hearing na talagang hindi mo na nakayanan at kinailangan mong lumabas. Paano mo na tatagalan ang paghihintay ng hustisya?
Kailangang tumagal ako sa hustisya na hinaharap namin. Kasi pag wala nang makitang matapang at magsasalita sa hustisya na hinahanap namin, palagay ko magiging mabura ito pagdating ng araw sa isipan ng mga tao at ayun ang hindi ko gustong mangyari. Sa totoo lang, ano, kahit na ako aaminin ko nahihirapan akong intindihin yung lingwahe ng mga abogado, pero sa mababaw na pananaw ko sa nangyari at anong motibo na bakit sila pinatay, sa lugar kung paano sila pinatay, yung mga tao na nagsasabi ng mga witness na sila mismo ang nagsasabi na si ganito nga, si ganyan nga ang nag-order na ipahinto sila. Yun, isang bagay na lang na punto na yun na bakit pa natin patagalin ito na nandito naman, kailangan nating marinig yung buong katotohanan kung sino nga ba talaga.
So para sa iyo, ang pag-live coverage ng pagdinig ay solusyon para mapabilis.
Oo naman. Bakit sinasabi ng Supreme Court, sila lang ba ang magaling? Sila lang ba ang magaling maghusga? Mm-hmm. Pati taong bayan, magaling yung chef. Sinasabi
pero
ko sa iyo.
Pero syempre kailangan nating sundan ang proseso.
Pero minsan kasi ang proseso, bakit sinasabi ko ng ganun? Itong Supreme Court ba, nalalaman ba nila kung ano nararamdaman namin? Tama yun, magaling sila magbalakas sa batas. Pero anong klaseng batas? Pantay ba yun? Pantay ba yun para sa mahirap at saka sa mayaman? Pantay ba yun sa walang alam at saka mayroong alam? Ito na yung panahon natin ngayon na hindi na tayo dapat magbulag-bulagan. Yun lang parati kung sinasabi-sabi ko, bakit ganito nangyari ito? Siguro para mabuksan ang kaisipan ng bawat mamamayang Pilipino na ang hustisya ay hindi lang para sa mangmang. Ang hustisya ay para sa lahat. Mayaman man yan o mahirap.
Commissioner Cardona, what is pending in the Commission on Human Rights concerning the Maguindanao Massacre? Because if justice is slow in the courts, then perhaps the victims' families can hope for resolution as well in the CHR.
We are on this on several fronts. One is our continuing monitoring of the process ongoing, meaning the trial. So we do have officers that are actually attending and looking into what's happening inside and outside of the courts. And then our continuing investigation, and we're continuing to gather additional information, mm-hmm. gather additional evidence, probably witnesses, in the hope of finding or resolving that indeed, because I mean there is no question that there was a human rights violation.
But no determination.
Who committed this? I mean,
no determination of guilt or
No. We are not a court, but we can say that there was a human rights violation in this case, and who are the perpetrators? We can do that.
Mm-hmm.
But as to adjudication of guilt, we do not go into that because that is a criminal process. What we can say is that there was a human rights violation, and who are the perpetrators? Mm-hmm. But more than that, more than this massacre, we're also looking into the alleged killings and violations prior to the Maguindanao Massacre. Mm-hmm. We're still continuing in our investigation in these cases.
But is there a report that pinpoints accountability in the Maguindanao Massacre?
Yes, but we are continuing to strengthen our facts and evidence.
Can they take the report of the CHR and bring it to International Court of Justice, or will this be useful in a civil case or even in a criminal case?
Well, Cez, we actually attempted to go to the ASEAN Intergovernmental Commission on Human Rights.
Mm-hmm.
No? We wanted to underscore the fact that since all of the accused were state agents, that there is an obvious breach of the state obligation mm-hmm. to protect and promote the human rights mm-hmm. of the victims. No? Unfortunately,
The Intergovernmental Commission has proven itself to be a toothless tiger.
Mm-hmm.
The Indonesian representative to the commission actually went out, received our complaint, and regretfully informed us that a decision has been made by the commission members that they will not accept individual complaints and that they will instead focus on their role as a dissemination body in the region.
Mm-hmm.
So if at all we were able to prove really that the ASEAN Intergovernmental Commission as of this time is still completely irrelevant and immaterial to those who have mm-hmm. become victims of human rights violations.
What about the United Nations?
Mm-hmm. Well, there will be an opportunity for that, no? Because we have ratified what is known as the optional protocol to the International Covenant mm-hmm. on Civil and Political Rights. No? And we could allege a failure of a duty to mm-hmm. Protect and promote and to give the victims a remedy under domestic law, but we have still to exhaust domestic remedies and hence mm-hmm. our participation in the criminal case and the many other cases that we have filed, no, against the police, an admin case, and the AFP, no, including General Kaiton and Colonel Gislani.
Attorney Prima Tinsayas, you have filed on behalf of the Freedom Fund for Journalists a disbarment case against one of the counsels of Andal Ampatuan Jr.
Yes, ma'am.
This kind of complicates the case further, would you say?
I don't think so.
Mm-hmm.
The lawyer against whom we filed the disbarment case represents actually two accused, junior and senior, although we know senior has not been arraigned yet.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think it would complicate matters.
A point of clarification, sorry to interrupt. Senior has not filed, is not mm-hmm. joining Zaldi in the appeal, in the petition before the Court of Appeals?
We have separate petitions.
Okay. All right. Yeah. So continue, attorney.
Actually, the Court of Appeals before whom the petition for certiorari of Andal Senior mm-hmm. is being heard has already issued an order to all parties to submit their respective memoranda.
Mm-hmm.
Anyway, going back, I think the other lawyers will agree with me. Everyone has the right to representation in court, to be heard, to have his day in court. And with due respect to the defense counsels in this case, I do believe that we are first and foremost officers of the court, and there's a limitation as to how we conduct our defense. Mm-hmm. And the disbarment case is based on the ground that there were several violations on the part of said lawyer when it comes to our code of professional responsibility, Seth.
TJ, what do you have from our friends on Twitter?
Hi, Seth. Well, we're getting lots of reactions from our friends, some of them giving comments, some of them giving their voicing their feelings, their emotions. This one coming from Paolo Medina. He says, remembering and honoring the 58, we will never forget. The estimate that the trial will last for years is unacceptable. Our next comment came from Marvian. She says, ask ko lang po na di kaya pera ang kumokontrol sa Maguindanao Massacre. That's why mabagal ang pag-usit ito. I guess it's also important to lower this to the level of the people who don't really follow trials so much. And these are mm-hmm. things that go through their minds. I don't know who could answer this from our panel,
okay.
Test. If this could be appeased or explained, if this is
well,
a possibility.
Well, Attorney Kinsayas was hinting at that. So, yeah, money being used. How do you see it? How is it being employed?
Remember when Attorney Rick Diaz of NBI came out in public claiming that someone tried to get or, request that they be granted access to a particular witness who was then under the NBI custody? The news then was that the offer was between 5 and 10 million. So I suppose there must be some grain of truth because they say, there's no smoke if there's no fire.
We'll be taking a short break now. When we return, we'll delve more into how the families are coping with the tragedy, as well as how the massacre has changed journalism in the country. Do stay with us on ANC Presents.